timely and well-distributed rainfall. The fact that the bulk of crop production in the region depends on rain-fed agriculture makes our region vulnerable to adverse climatic conditions, a situation that called upon us to put policies and strategies in place in order to reduce and mitigate the impact of drought and floods, and to make the agriculture and fisheries sectors in the region more resilient to adverse climatic conditions. In this regard, it is important for us as ministers responsible for agriculture, food security, fisheries and aquaculture in the SADC region to ensure that the decisions that we have taken are effectively and practically implemented on the ground. In addition, it is also imperative that our officials devise and implement strategies that will enhance our preparedness to respond in good time and effectively to the effects of the increasingly volatile climatic conditions. To this effect, we should continue to formulate and implement policies that support and promote climatic smart agriculture, such as conservation agriculture and the use of improved seeds. Such policies and strategies will not only enable us to achieve regional food security objectives and targets, but will also put us in a position to contribute towards the attainment of the continental goals that are stipulated in Agenda 2063 of the African Union and those of the comprehensive African agriculture programs, as well as to the goals of the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development of the United Nations. Therefore, in our deliberation today, we should ensure that solutions are found to address food security challenges that are currently facing the region. We should particularly focus on rural investment, infrastructure development, and appropriate technologies to reduce the long-term effects of climate variability and climate change on the food security through the provision of incentives that will motivate farmers to adopt better agricultural techniques and practices and encourage aquaculture development. In addition, we need to strengthen our national and strategic grain reserve facilities. Honorable ministers, Your Excellencies, participants, I am informed that this meeting will discuss a number of items, amongst others, the regional food security situation, transboundary animal diseases, harmonized seed regulatory system, implementation of the regional agriculture policy, fisheries and aquaculture, as well as the blue economy strategy. While deliberating on these items, it is therefore important to highlight that it will not be sufficient for us to take good decisions and to formulate good policies if these decisions and policies are not practically implemented for the benefit of our people. In addition, the implementation of these decisions and policies is only possible if all member states commit themselves to honor their obligations towards the implementation of the regional programs and initiatives. It is only through our timely contribution and the effective implementation programs and initiatives that the region will be able to feed the estimated 30 million people who currently is food insecure in our region, and to take the SADC Agricultural Fisheries and Aquaculture Development Program forward. I am mindful of the fact that the region has been experiencing economic headwinds. However, I would still like to humbly request all member states, through you, honorable ministers, deputy ministers, high commissioners, ambassadors representing your countries, to make effort where possible to avail resources for the implementations of our regional programs in order for us to address food insecurity, poverty and unemployment, particularly amongst the youth.